I am attending the ASH meeting, especially because I'm very interested in the new advances in multiple myeloma, and especially because I'm going to present important results from Spanish myeloma group during this ASH meeting. I'm going to present the results of a multicenter trial conducted in elderly and treated multiple myeloma patients with a novel and less intensive bortezomib-based approach of therapy in order to try to optimize the treatment of elderly and treated myeloma patients. We have decided to reduce the intensity of the therapy, but to prolong the therapy with a maintenance therapy, and we were able to maintain the efficacy and even to improve and decrease significantly the toxicity, especially the peripheral neuropathy. Yeah, it's an important question because the introduction of novel agents in the treatment of multiple myeloma patients has actually changed the outcome of these patients. However, the introduction of bortezomib, thalidomide, or even lenalidomide is important because they have demonstrated to be very effective in multiple myeloma patients as single agent. But we can't forget that in vitro studies and also in clinical trials and in the clinical practice, we have observed a synergistic effect when these novel agents were combined with conventional chemotherapy, such as anthracycline, alkylating agents. So I think one important message is that we can't forget these conventional agents because they have a clear synergistic effect when they were combined with novel agents. Carfilzomib and pomalidomide are novel agents. Carfilzomib is a proteasome inhibitor, the second generation of proteasome inhibitor. The first generation, the drug bortezomib was the first proteasome inhibitor, and now carfilzomib is the second generation. It's important because carfilzomib has demonstrated to be very effective in multiple myeloma patients, even when they had previously received bortezomib, the first generation of proteasome inhibitors. And in addition, carfilzomib appears not induce peripheral neuropathy, that is the most important bortezomib related side effect. So I think it's an important drug because it represents a next step in the treatment of myeloma patients. And a similar situation with pomalidomide. It's an immunomodulatory drug in the like thalidomide and lenalidomide, and pomalidomide is the third immunomodulatory drug, and it's the same situation. Their principal characteristics is to be able to overcome resistance to the previous immunomodulatory drugs, and in addition, to try to improve the toxicity profile. So I think both drugs are going to be very important in the near future of, in the treatment of multiple myeloma patients. In this ASH 2019, they are going to be presented important results about all these novel drugs. Carfilzomib, pomalidomide, and another series of novel drugs that they are going to replace bortezomib, thalidomide, and lenalidomide. I think in this meeting we are going to see consolidated results about bortezomib, thalidomide, and lenalidomide, and promising efficacy results with the new family of novel drugs, carfilzomib, pomalidomide, HDAC inhibitors, etc. In clinical practice, it's more difficult to treat patients because we have at the moment in our hands a lot of novel drugs. However, in this ASH meeting, I think we are going to consolidate the results about bortezomib, thalidomide, lenalidomide. We have to try to individualize the treatment of our patients according to the characteristics of the patients, because we know a lot of about bortezomib, thalidomide, and lenalidomide, and we have to reserve these other novel drugs to include patients in clinical trials in order to know better their mechanism of action, their toxicity, and also their activity. So my conclusion would be to individualize the treatment according to the personal characteristics of the patients, because bortezomib, thalidomide, and lenalidomide had a different toxicity profile, and it is possible to individualize the treatment. For young patients, today the standard of care is an induction therapy, probably with a novel drug, bortezomib or lenalidomide, plus a conventional chemotherapy plus corticosteroids, a short induction therapy, followed by autologous stem cell transplant. And the question is, after autologous stem cell transplant, a consolidation or maintenance therapy? And for young patients, for elderly patients, autologous stem cell transplant is not considered as a standard of therapy, and probably an induction therapy with a modified and non very intensive induction therapy, followed probably by consolidation of maintenance therapy during a limited period of time.